Hello everyone, we are here to cover Bitlocker and Bitlocker To Go. This is the conversation of encrypting your drive. Whether it's the fixed data drive, which is the hard drive inside of your tower or laptop, or if we're going to be talking Bitlocker To Go, which is going to be using USB flash drives and removable storage. Either way, we want to encrypt our contents so our data is safe. Let's get to it. I'm going to go ahead and click on my start button for Windows, and I'm going to go to Control Panel. And I go to Control Panel, here we are. In both Windows 10 and a Windows 8 and Windows 7, you're going to be able to utilize BitLocker. Windows 7 Enterprise and Ultimate works with it, so does Windows 8 Pro and Enterprise. On top of that, if you've got Windows 10 like me, Windows 10 Pro, Enterprise, and Education all support BitLocker. So I'm going to go ahead and click on BitLocker Drive Encryption inside of my Control Panel. And when this opens up, what we're going to see here is my operating system drive, which is my fixed data drive. It's my C disk. We have that, and I have removable data drive, which is my flash drive, named important, which is my E drive. Now we're going to start first with the removable drive, because these are the things you take with you wherever you go, and they're very easy to lose. And if you ever have sensitive data on one, I'd like the contents to be encrypted, where people can't access it unless they can use the decrypt password. So I'm going to go ahead here and click on turn on BitLocker on the flash drive that I plugged into my machine. Now, BitLocker starts up, it looks at my flash drive, and says, how do you want to unlock this drive? This is going to be the way that we can decrypt the contents of my flash drive. Now, I can use a password or a smart card or both as a combination. Now, smart card is something you have to insert into your machine, and as long as that's inserted, we're going to be able to have the contents of the flash drive decrypted. I'm not going to have a smart card on me, so I'm going with use a password. So I'll create my password and type it in twice, and this password is what I will use to decrypt the contents of my flash drive whenever I plug it in to any machine. With that being done, we get a little, hey, make sure you have a recovery key. If you do lose that password or you lose your smart card, if we had selected that, the recovery key can be used to access our drive. I'd be very wary of saving it to a file on my machine. We could always save it to our cloud account, but I prefer to print it. And after I print it, I'm gonna put it in a safe in my office. We can go ahead and click next, and now we get a confusing question. Do you wanna encrypt the used disk space, or do you wanna encrypt the entire flash drive? If you've ever deleted confidential or personal information from your flash drive, you wanna encrypt the entire drive. Because if you're only encrypting the used disk space, you're only encrypting the current files on the drive. But if you've ever deleted files, that space that can be literally pulled out of the drive and reconstructed of your deleted files with analysis tools is not going to be encrypted. So we're going to encrypt the entire drive, which includes any empty space and used space. And that empty space might not really be empty. There could be deleted files there. So I'm going to encrypt the entire drive. Now, if I'm going to use this flash drive on different computer systems, including different Windows operating systems, I want to make sure I use compatible mode. If you're only going to be using this flash drive on the latest Windows 10 systems as you move around your flash drive, you can click and be very comfy with the new encryption mode. But the issue is if you try to use this flash drive with this newer encryption mode, which is Windows 10 later versions, it might not be compatible with other operating systems that you're trying to open up your flash drive on. So I'm going to choose compatible mode because this is a USB flash drive and I will be moving and plugging it into different computers. With that selected, it says you will be able to unlock this drive using the password you created. We're about to encrypt it and I'm going to click start encrypting. This is a small flash drive. The encryption process can go pretty quickly. It's actually a 256 meg flash drive, which is awesome for this video because a 16 gig would take a while. So it's encrypting the drive, and while it's doing that, you can see some of the options down below. When we're done with encrypting our drive, we can back up the recovery key again. I can change that password being used, get rid of the password completely. We didn't add a smart card before, but if we wanted to have that be an allowable way to open up our flash drive and decrypt the contents, we could. On top of that, we can have our system to set up an auto unlock where it automatically unlocks the flash drive. And lastly, I can turn off BitLocker, which will decrypt permanently the entire flash drive, and my files won't be encrypted anymore on it. So the encryption of E is complete. I'll go ahead and click close. Now let's take a look at what happens with it. So I just ejected my USB flash drive from the computer that has BitLocker To Go on it. I'm gonna plug it back in. I got my file explorer up here. And check it out, the first message I get is, your flash drive is not accessible? You're like, no, it's done for. Not really. I'll click OK, And we see here it says my USB drive E with a lock on it. I can double click on that and check out the pop-up I get. BitLocker with E drive. Enter your password to unlock it. So I'll put in my password and I will click unlock. And now what's going to happen is it's going to open up on my screen and check it out. I've got my important files of 1 through 5. And now any files I put here and then eject the flash drive, those new files I add into here are going to be encrypted utilizing BitLocker. So this is BitLocker To Go. Let's switch back over and let's go into BitLocker regarding my fixed system drive. Now we've got our BitLocker set up with our encrypted USB flash drive. But let's move on to the fixed data drive, which is where our operating system is stored and the data itself. So we want to encrypt that data on that fixed operating system drive. So I'm going to go ahead and click on turn on BitLocker. And what I get here is an error message. It says the device can't use a TPM. TPM is our trusted platform module. That is our chip on the motherboard of our system. This is for hardware-based storage. This is where we're going to have our hashed passwords and keys, digital certs. This is all stored on a TPM chip. Now, if your system isn't set up to use this or your system doesn't even have it, there are other ways to still using BitLocker using software. So to do that, I'm going to click on my start button. I'm going to type in gpedit followed by .msc. And we have here this, let's say, console doc. And really what it comes down to is we have an editor that pops up with a snap-in, and I need to change a system setting. And for me, that's in Administrative Templates, Windows Components, and then inside of there, BitLocker Drive Encryption. Now, inside of this area, I'm going to go into the Operating System Drives, and here's an option that says Require Additional Authentication at Startup. I'm going to double-click on that, and for this one, I'm going to checkmark Enabled. And this is going to allow me to use software to do my encryption for my drive and not have the key stored on a TPM chip. So I'll click apply and okay. With that closed off for this group policy editor, I'm going to click on turn on BitLocker a second time. And this time now it's loading up. So instead of using the TPM chip, we're going to be able to store our keys manually. We can either insert a USB flash drive in order to have our drive decrypt to access our contents, or we can use a password. I don't want to rely on a flash drive, so I'm going to click enter a password. I'll choose a password, which will be used to decrypt my entire hard disk drive of my machine. Click next. Now, just like we saw before with the flash drive, with BitLocker To Go, we can have a method for recovering if we lose that password. Again, I would print it, and I'll have this thing then stored in my safe at my office. Go ahead and click next. Just like we saw before regarding the flash drive, encrypt only the used disk space, which is the files that are currently on the drive, or encrypt the entire drive, including that free space where you could have had deleted files. So I would do the entire drive. Now, just for speed of the video though, this is a hard disk drive. I am going to use the used disk space only, just for the speed of the video. Again, regarding compatibility modes, I'm not planning on taking my fixed hard drive out of my computer tower or my laptop and moving it to a different system. So leaving the best encryption mode possible, which is the new one for fixed drives, I'm keeping that. So I'll go ahead and click next. And now we can have a system checkmark checked off. And this will actually make sure that we can utilize the recovery encryption keys correctly before we just literally encrypt the entire drive. Think of this as saying, hey, go ahead and encrypt your drive without making sure that it's going to be able to decrypt. Ooh, that would be scary. So we want this checkmarked as an extra safeguard, and I can go ahead and click continue. At this point in time, I'm going to get a pop-up that says my computer must be restarted, and after the restart, our video will continue. So the computer is rebooting, I get my BIOS splash page, and instant BitLocker. We need to enter our password to unlock this drive. Until we put in our password, my hard drive is encrypted and the data on it is encrypted and inaccessible. So if I enter my password here, it would take me into my Windows loading screen and I'd finally be back on my desktop. So this is BitLocker To Go and BitLocker on our fixed drive. Thanks for watching. Practice and